नमस्ते, दिस इज़ एमएससी सेकेंड सेमेस्टर क्लास ऑफ फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री एंड द टॉपिक इज वेरिएशन मेथड। फॉर द काइंड ऑफ पोटेंशियल्स दर अराइज इन एटॉमिक एंड मॉलिक्यूलर स्ट्रक्चर द हेल्मिंटियन एंड एच इज अ हेल्मिंटियन ऑपरेटर दैट इज बाउंडेड फ्रॉम द बिलो बिकॉज इट इज़ हेल्मिंटियन एंड इट प्रोसेस अ कम्प्लीट सेट ऑफ ऑर्थो नॉर्मल वेव फंक्शंस साइन जे एनी फंक्शंस थीटा that depends on the same spatial and spin variables on which H operates the and obeys the same boundary conditions, that is sin J or B can be expanded in this complete set. Then theta is equals to EJ, CJ and sin J. The expectation value of the Hamiltonian for any such functions can be expressed in terms of its CJ coefficients and the exact energy levels EJ of H as follows. In it expressing by this expression, if the function theta is normalized, the sum of J and CJ square is equal to unity because H is bounded. From below, all the EJ must be greater than and equal to the lowest energy. Combining the latter two observations allow the energy expectations value of theta to be used to produce a very important inequality. Theta H, theta is equals greater than E0. The equality can hold only if theta is equals to sin 0. If psi contains components along any of the others sin j, the energy of the theta will be is zero. The upper boundary property forms the basis of the so-called variation method in which trial wave functions theta are constructed. To guarantee that theta obeys all the boundary conditions that the exact psi j do and that theta is the proper spin and space symmetry and is a function of the same spatial and spin coordinates as psi j, with the parameters embedded in theta whose optimal values are to be determined by making a minimum. So this is a perfect acceptable to vary any parameters in psi to attain the lowest possible value for H theta, because the proof and above constant the expectations value to be above the true lowest wave state energy is zero for any theta. The philosophy then it is that the theta is getting the lowest, theta as theta is the best because its expectation value is close to the exact energy. Quite often a trial wave function is depicted in a linear combination of other functions. Theta is sum of J, CJ and theta J. In these cases, one says that a linear variation calculation is being performed. The set of functions theta J are usually constructed to obey all the boundary conditions that the exact state psi obeys to be functions of the same coordinates as psi and to be of the same spatial and spin symmetry as psi. Beyond these conditions, the theta J are nothing more than members of a set of functions that are conveniently to deal with and that can in principle be made complete if more and more such functions are included. For such a trial wave functions, the energy depends quadratically on the linear variation CJ coefficient. Theta H theta is the sum of IJ, CI, CJ is lesser than theta I, H, Q, theta J. Minimization of this energy with the constraint that theta remains normalized gives rise to so-called secular and wave values, wave vector problems. In the functions theta j are orthonormal, then the overlap matrix X reduces to the unit matrix and the above generalized wave value problems reduces to the more familiar form. Sum of J, H, I, J, C, J is equals to E. CI. The secular problem in either form has as many wave values even and wave vectors CIG as a dimension of the HIJ matrix as theta. It can also be shown that between successive pair of the wave values obtained by solving the secular problem, at least one exact wave value must occur. This observation is referred to as the bracketing theorem. Variational method, in particular the linear variational method, are the most widely are approximation technique in quantum chemistry. To implement such a method, one need to know the Hamiltonian and whose energy level are sought, and one need to construct a trial wave function in which some flexibility exists. So this is about variation function, variation method. Thank you so much. Hope you understand.